So it's been a couple of days now since the new Vault weapons were released into Battlefield 2042 for update 2.2. And now I've had a few days to settle in and test them all out, and I'm going to give you my thoughts as a little update video to update 2.2, a follow-up just like with update 2.1. So let's get straight into the three new weapons, how I was running them, and how I like them individually. Let's start with my least favourite, and that would actually surprisingly be the ACW-R. I love this gun in Battlefield 3 Portal, but taking it over to All Out Warfare, it seemed to underperform, but not for the reasons I really expected it might do. What I mean by this is its damage is decent, its headshot multiplier seems really, really good, but I found myself running out of ammo quite often due to its high rate of fire. Stat and performance wise, it should be a really good gun, but for some reason it didn't quite gel with me just yet. That being said, its recoil with a grip on is basically non-existent. You can beam people with it and it does make for a good assault rifle at medium ranges. It did remind me kind of the S-Far with its limited recoil, but I don't like using the S-Far that much. After I tier 1'd it, I didn't really touch it again, even though it's a really good weapon. I just enjoy different types of weapons over these ones. Overall though, it is a solid choice for an assault rifle. Just for my own personal reasons, I don't like it as much as the other two weapons on the list. Next in the SMG class, we have the new AK. I love this thing. When I first started using it, when it came out, it seemed to underperform quite heavily, but I think this was because of netcode in the first couple of hours when the update launched. After that, I've been using it as a hip-fire machine with the underbarrel laser. It's great, it's so much fun, and even with an extended barrel and a grip, you can hit some long shots that you wouldn't really expect to if you tap fire. It definitely is attuned to shorter ranges, but it does have a little bit of versatility in there. I do just love the look of wooden AKs though, so I'm probably biased, but I have been loving using this. One thing I failed to point out in my last video that is present on this gun is that we now have different colored lasers. I did mention the laser overhaul and how they look different now, but I didn't mention the different colors, and you can see there's a green one on the AK. It's really nice looking. It creates for a really nice visual when your teammates are running them and when you're running them yourselves, and they actually work as intended now. They make hit fire really viable, but they do give you away, obviously, if you're pointing out in a position, maybe around a corner, your enemy can see your laser sticking around. But it does help with those hit fire moments, and I do just love running this weapon hit fire in places like D1 and Orbital. So there we go, my second favorite weapon out of the three is the AK. I would recommend using it. And finally, we have the gun that surprised me the most, the Rex. I'd used it in Battlefield 3 Portal before, and I didn't like it that much. I'm not sure why, maybe it's been adjusted for All Out Warfare, but I find myself really enjoying it. I've been using it as my go-to secondary for the past couple of days. It's definitely my favorite. I played around with the M44 at launch, like I said in my last video, and I found the rate of fire to be a bit too slow, even though the damage was good. But using the Rex basically solves all that. It's got 6 shots, but you can fire them very, very fast compared to the M44. CQB engagements are pretty damn decent with it, and headshots are also solid. And I've been having so much fun with this little hand cannon that I've actually been running it as a primary for the last 2 days or so. Its sounds and kick are satisfying to use, and it's also got a really neat little secret reload where you spin the gun on your finger. You can see it kind of startled me for a second because I didn't expect it, but I love these touches on weapons like these, and the Rex is just a really fun one. For the practical use of it, I've been running the P51 since Season 2 started, but I've now replaced it with this revolver, which is probably a stupid decision, but it's just so cool and so fun that I kind of have to. Anyway, this drop of Vault weapons is probably my favourite. They all gel well in terms of gameplay. I'm not quite sure what the issue is with the ACW, but it's more than likely just a me thing. Anyway, that concludes everything from this update now. If you missed my review of the rest of the update, you can go watch that a couple videos ago. I give my thoughts on Orbital, persistent servers, and all of the changes that have been brought into the update. But what did you think of these Vault weapons and the update in general? Do let me know in the comments below. And I'm also feeling creative, so enjoy this little montage of moments over the last couple days with these weapons. See ya.